Hello everyone, welcome back to the Binding of Isaac, something birth. We're going to do a greed run, but I'm going to random it, sort of mix it all up a little bit, you know, throw all the things in the fire, make it all fucking perfect. That's exactly what we wanted, is a fucking blue baby. Fucking greed run straight off the bat. Let's take 1 HP and make some poop. I think what we want to do here is see what's available. There is a chest. Probably spend our newfound spirit heart on this, which is actually a really good idea. Well done, me. Get rid of the poops. We want to make sure we've got as much room as possible, because on a greed mode run, you're going to have more trouble at the start of the game than you are further on, because once you get some money, you can start buying some items. No, I don't want that, but we do have the D6 in here, which is a much, much better spacebar item. So we can, once we get some cash... Why did that do that funny maneuver just now? Once we get some cash, we can think about finding ourselves taking the D6. Why have I not... Oh, I've got some... Yes, we did get some more money. At some point, we're probably going to want to think about stepping on this button, because there's no way we have the DPS to keep up with this. But at the same time, I want to make sure we've got enough money to buy the D6 sooner rather than later. The reason for that is that if we... Oh, that was a terrible dodge. If we do it wrong, well, first of all, we have to make sure we've got enough HP to actually step on this without hurting, without dying. This doesn't seem like it's going to last very long, if I had to guess. We want to, if possible, get as many charges on the D6 as we can. See, that's the problem right there. We can't afford anything, but we had to stop, but now we can't push the button the second time. And, oh my god, the little son of a bitch was a chasey type one. Like, these things die easily, I guess, but at the same time, you don't really want to be in that situation. We can't push the button now. It's not an option. But we also do not have the DPS to beat this in the 10 seconds that it gives us to do so, so hopefully we can beat the next wave without too much trouble whilst this one is still going. Oh god, this is going to be awful. Oh, what happened? I'm alive. Case of holding your breath at this point, hoping for the best. Try and stop the spiders from aggroing you if possible. That way you've got more room to maneuver dodging these shots. The more of these little diglet fingers we can get out of the way, then the better we'll do. Well, we'll just keep doing this, I think. Let's see what's in this shop. There is a reroll if we choose to accept it. Maybe going into the curse room was not the greatest of ideas. There is a coin in there, but it's not that big a deal at this stage. All stats is kind of a little bit better than just the single HP we got in the last one, but still not really giving us the start that we need. It's not the amazing upgrade. I mean, it's going to be a little bit difficult as Blue Baby at the start of this game, because it's not like we can take the Spirit Hearts from the shop, because there aren't any. We're not going to really benefit from any HP upgrades at all. I feel like I can probably ignore that... head thingy for now. Actually, to be honest, this halo pickup has actually made a considerable difference. We're not really getting any consumables from all of this, so I guess a lot of the things that you'd normally expect to be a benefit to you are not going to happen. Which is why greed mode is just that, and it's different, I suppose. But of course, as Blue Baby, we're not going to get any of the expected benefits from any of the expected sources. Luckily, those things all helped me out with the wave that has been around for, you know, most of my adult life, apparently. And it's my favourite enemies of all time that I know exactly how to deal with. I think we're doing a lot better right now, so there is that, than we were on the previous one, where we were not doing well at all. This is the 8th wave as well, so we don't have to worry. Which means we've got the maximum benefit from the money for this, which actually gives me a little bit more confidence than we had just now. We can buy, I think, although we could buy a key, there is more money coming up. Could be some money in here. Oh, okay. And I think wire coat hanger, the tier upgrade, is that much more important to us right now. And the soul. So I don't want to call it a win. Obviously, we still have quite a lot of not dying to do. That's definitely part of it. Still Blue Baby. It's not like we've... solved all of our problems, because one of our main problems is the fact that we are Blue Baby. But with the soul to keep us alive, with the coat hanger to keep us in good DPS, and the halo to actually make that DPS slightly better than it used to be. If I can kill this before the 5 seconds, that would be super. There we go. I think it gives us an extra... Oh, what is this? I think it gives us an extra bit of cash if you finish it early. I know it gives you cash if you don't push the button. I really wish I had bombs right now. But I'm not sure if it gives you more cash if you finish before your time is up. Which would be nice, because of course more cash is more value. And we're here to get our final item, don't forget. That was a very interesting interaction, did you notice? Our soul pushed away a homing shot, and therefore had no idea what to do. Of course, we can't push the button now because we're stuck here. This is the last wave. We can't cancel the last wave. We're actually doing okay. Ooh, that was a very timely jump, I have to be honest. You know, credit where credit's due, the game got me. Having a soul push away tears that are trying to attract themselves to us is a very strange situation, but at least it didn't hit us. That's an important thing. We have 9 cents. Now, it could buy us another key, but there's no point buying a key really at this stage. And the reason for that, mostly, is it's 5 cents. It's always going to be 5 cents, but sometimes it could be 3 cents, so saying it's always going to be 5 cents is slightly a lie. Wow, you're down there, aren't you? They go a long way, actually. Very surprising how far these things can actually travel. At least we're doing some decent amount of damage to those things. The dips are popping in one shot, which just goes to show that Blue Baby with the halo is... much better damage upgrade than we've had from some of our runs more recently. I think this is fine. I'm trying to get this deal with the devil mostly for its own sake. There's a chance, of course, that we can't take it. Pretty good chance. And even in that situation, that still gives us the same deal with the angel sort of strategy, option, chance, dynamic, paradigm, etc. that you get in a normal run. So I think we can not really afford to take this. I really hate these things because I have no idea how to hit them, because if you can hit them, they can hit you. Just wait for them to teleport. So we've only got 4 spirit hearts, which is not good enough. I'm kind of tempted to spend one on the curse room, but I'm not going to do it. We haven't got any bombs to find a secret room either. Yeah, we've got some good stuff on this floor, so I'm happy with that. I'm really looking for a floor that has spirit hearts, but even better, the D20. So we get a free item, which is just 1 spirit heart. I will take it. We could do the bomb then. There isn't one. But I suppose we buy the key, because there isn't a cheaper key. Don't really care about the only trinket that's available. I think the bombs are actually worth it, even though the other one is a theoretically better space where I am, especially down here. Hot bombs is A, bomb synergy, but B, it's some bombs. And honestly, I think... it could be offensively useful, and also it can get us into stone chests and things like that, but otherwise we would be at a loss to deal with, really. For example, put this here. Of course, hot bombs will be creating the fires to make the bombs that we do have that much more offensively potent, so... I mean, it's a difficult choice. Having loads of extra coins, in principle, could have been really good, but it could have been shit. You know, variants could have just given us no extra coins at all out of all that. Unlikely, but still, we could have struck out on the coins from the wooden nickel, which would have been sad. We're really not doing a whole lot of damage to these things either. We're only on wave 5 to 8 that we're going to have to deal with. But I didn't realise you were going to get behind me. That was very sneaky indeed. Hopefully these ones will just pop into nothingness. Having a bit of trouble here, but I'm going to keep going. We are on wave 7, so we've basically got 1 left. Not that big a deal. We did get the 3 spirit hearts from the soul, so our HP is fine, but I have lost a lot, which is not too confidence-inducing. I'd like to get into... I don't know. I was going to say I'd like to get into the item room, but obviously we've been there. It wasn't that great. It wasn't hugely inspiring. I guess we'd do that. I don't really want either of these, either. This could be a secret room. It's not. Do you want to go into the curse room? It could do us some good. It could be shit. It's 2 keys, so that's basically 10 cents right there, which is 1 spirit heart's worth, but there's no spirit heart for sale, so... You know, we're not really getting the huge benefits that I would hope for. Especially from greed mode. You know, we like to see slightly more interesting stuff in greed mode than we're currently receiving. I'm hoping, unfortunately, they don't explode each other with each other's troll bombs. I'm hoping to see basically any of the fun you can get from just being able to buy infinite items. And if we can find a D20 and get our crown of light the same way we got our godhead, then so be it. I have, you know, I've made peace, made my peace with that particular option. This is a champion version of a horn. It's throwing several of these little jokers at us all at once. Which I don't like very much. It's so tanky for little shitbags like they are. Now, is this the one that's gonna? No, it's a normal shot. It just had an extra ghost with it. Fair enough. Fair enough. We know how to deal with a haunt at least. I mean, first world boss. Probably the harder of the first world bosses, but we are not on the first floor. In fact, that's interesting. We are actually on the caves and we're fighting the haunt. And it nearly shot me, and I didn't let it because I am a champion, mad pro MLG level Isaac player, and don't need to forget it. Well, I think we fight, excuse me, we fight our nightmare mode bosses, which is only at 3 slots, so that's actually really good. Because they can, if not hurt each other, they can at least explode these things that they create. With their own shots and each other. But hopefully we'll get a deal with the angel. Maybe get our crown of light slightly more organically than trying to force it with cheap D20 plays. But look, we're playing Blue Baby on green mode. That's a novelty in and of itself. And this time we have played nearly 2 whole floors of Blue Baby without dying miserably. It's another deal with the devil. Not my favourite, but at least we get some HP out of it. And, again, we haven't got any precedent, so we could continue with the original plan, which is get Crown of Light from an angel, which is usually the only way you're going to do it. Is there anything we actually want in here? I mean, honestly, we save our money. If there's nothing we want, we save our money. I don't think the Lucky Foot is any value whatsoever in greed mode. Having a few extra bombs doesn't necessarily help from the matchbook there. So, I'm going to suggest no. We can always go straight into this shop, of course. There is a spirit heart, which will be replenishing, and it's only 5 cents. And there is a bomb. I don't think we take it yet. We see what's in the other ones. You know, we try and get as much of a play as we can. Well, there's a bunch of, hopefully, spirit hearts right here. Yes, 3. Very good. Well, that's us sorted on HP, at least for now. Which means what we can start doing is re-rolling these and hopefully get some sort of damage upgrade. I think we take the syringe. Simply because it's a syringe. Now, this gives us money, and I can't remember how much. If we take it, it means we don't have to buy keys anymore. But we do have 2 keys. We should go into here. Honestly, I'm kind of hoping that we now get the D6 out of our rerolls here. I think we use bomb for this so that we have our money available to us to buy whatever else we want. It does reroll the whole shop, including the spirit heart there. Blank card is interesting, especially if a card drops somehow, or a chest appears, or anything really. There are many ways that blank card could be useful to us. You know, we could get blank card Yera, for example, if a Yera rune somehow shows up, e.g. on the shop. You know, blank card Hierophant would be really good. These are all shop plays, by the way. I think the only way we can get any cards is to buy them from the shop. I'm not a fan of this this particular level right now. We haven't taken any damage yet, but that's more by luck than judgment. There you go. Okay. I'm going to push the button. I'm not afraid to admit when I am beaten. And I have been defeaterated. Honestly, I was not sure whether that beam would kill that enemy. Now that I know, in future I will make that play on purpose. But I should have stayed put, because then I wouldn't have... And it would not have been hit. Stepped aside, you see. A 7-cent black candle is definitely worth it, even though the chances of getting some curse is not that great, and the curse is only going to last for 1 floor. Still not ideal to have found one. That's right, we don't want to pick these up necessarily. Just a bit of a Hail Mary on a secret room here. It could be really anywhere, which is why I'm not trying too hard. I'm going to hold out hope, keep playing these. We did get a damage upgrade. So we do have some... Look, it's a bit OP if you spend the entire time that I have to kill you. Unkillable. I'm just saying. You know, give me some chance. This guy is too fast. I can't kill him. Bombs. Got one. Fuck. Fires. Yeah, bring it on. Fires. Use the fire. Fire is your friend. Keeps you warm at night. Cooks your food. Kills the bacteria. Denatures the proteins to make them more easily digestible. And you know, carbohydrates and things like that. Fire does a lot. Cooking food is very important. Something we figured out a long time ago as a species. And it's something that's been very good to us. That's not my creep. And I have no idea why I would think it was. That's doing quite a lot of damage here, so I'm happy with this. But this is brownie, and I'm not happy with that. Just a drop of poop here. I can always hide behind it. I cannot hide behind it. I have shit. Just don't be near it. Wow, okay. I don't know how to dodge these shots. It's bad enough when they're round and I can see where they are. When they're corn-shaped, I have no idea. Some of the new Isaac enemies... No, it's a bit weird. When I first saw Afterbirth played... Hello, you're this already. I was thinking, you know, these enemies seem out of place. Weird. I don't know if that's just because they were new. I mean, they don't seem that out of place anymore, and I'm kind of used to it. But, this should be okay. Pardon me. Carrion Queen is not the easiest enemy by any stretch of the imagination, but at least we have a larger arena. I cannot believe that actually hit me just now. Mildly upsetting, I have to be honest. We have a larger arena. When this enemy is in the small room, it's basically impossible. Because there's nowhere to stand before it's turned around and shot you. It's not like Chubb. Chubb's hard enough to hit. At least we get our deal with the angel or devil. And don't forget, we don't have precedent, and it should use the same... same algorithm. Yeah, there we go. So we did get some HP. One of which is money. In principle. Do you want to reroll again? Or I think we should go down to the next floor at this stage. I don't really think there's a huge amount of value in spending money to reroll those. Except that you might be able to reroll them again before we run down to 15 cents and not be able to buy anything at all. But I mean, going down to the next floor is essentially rerolling anyway. I've got the same blinking item. Shoot the fire before it shoots you. We do have a reroll machine here as well, so we're kind of okay, but we'll check the free items first so that we don't reroll those items into these items and feel sad about it. We might as well take the belt. We probably should have taken Little Steven, actually, now that I remember the fact I didn't go in there. And we will take $3 bill. Honestly, the difference between having and not having Little Steven is not going to keep me awake, at least tonight. There's a second syringe, so that's what we really want there. And here's our card. It's two of spades. It would have been nice to know that was coming up. I mean, oh, I didn't mean to do that. That happens far too often. But that's okay. It happens sometimes. Oh, of course, $3 bill is what's giving us these tier effects right now. And of course, being hit twice is not a big deal because it just gives us a bunch more money. It's just we'd like to postpone that until it's strictly necessary. Entirely possible. I think possibly taking blank cards should have been the thing that we do. That's not very much money, I'm being honest. Because there was some chance that we got a card eventually from all our rerolls, right? I mean, it doesn't seem infeasible that we would eventually have one. And the poop is doing nothing for us. So even the potential in blank card is greater than the potential in the poop, even though the poop has some fairly decent potential, especially in terms of spirit hearts. Help. Let me out. Let's put poop here, that'll help. Oh my god, I hate these fucking creatures. You've seen these things. They won't leave me the fuck alone. At least I don't have to push a button. Like, we've run out of button plays. I will use the black heart. There is creep that I cannot see. That's not very fair, I'm just being honest. Oh my god. And that's why I hate those creatures. Oh, I'm gonna shit myself. Yeah, there's way more potential in blank card than there ever was in the poop. But we did have 15 more cents when we came down to this floor. Is blank card two of spades that big a deal? I will take the torn photo and hope that we can re-roll into, I don't know, anything. I'm not a fan of this though. Okay, so just four of these. By just I mean, oh my god, it's four of these. But at least it's not multiple. Ah, fuck. Of the stain? Multiple stain would be much harder. Trying to dodge more than one of those on the same room doing the same attack would be nigh on impossible, I have no doubt. Yes, frozen. I nearly got caught on that rock there. Just wait for the creep to dissipate. I can see it now. We got Curse of the Darkness. No, because we got the black candle. How could we possibly have Curse of the Darkness? It's kind of pesky when we have the Polycephalus tear effect. We don't have Polycephalus damage upgrade, which means we have no range and no damage. Downsides of decent items is that often they have downsides, I guess. That's one of these. Polycephalus or Polyphemus? Polycephalus. Be gone with your creep. Good. Well, that was a lot of effort. Maybe we can buy something. Like a spirit heart. No. Do you want to try the reroll? I think we try the reroll. We could always end up with just enough money anyway, as a result of the poop. And also this room, and also this round. Oh god, it's fucking two fucking champions of these bastards. Do not like champions of these bastards. Look at that! Fucking threw a spider right at me, which is extremely rude in any polite society. You don't know how I feel about spiders. Bit of an assumption that you've made there. Very presumptuous of you to assume that I would appreciate a gift of a spider. Especially one launched at me. Maybe if you presented to me in a nice velvet case, we might have felt differently about this, but as it stands. Don't like this Polyphemus nonsense right now. Our damage is good enough to at least get rid of those things before they infest the map completely and become a problem. This is what we like to see. Death's Touch versus these spiders. Even just the piercing aspect of those is super helpful. We have got rid of one. Very pleased to see that. I don't know where I was when it threw it. That's the problem. Nor do I know. What's happening? Let's go again. I mean, it might not last. It might not last long enough for the fact that we're on 20 minutes to matter. We're very slow. We have shit damage. This was an upsetting roll of Blue Baby here. But so be it. Oh my god, give me these things to start with. Try not to shoot that bomb, because that might be extremely useful at some point. At least these are only two shots each. We have to land them both. Good. Two, three, one, two. Oh, one, two, three. Three, one, two. One, two, three. Get in there, kill it. Oh god, they're after me. They're coming right for us. I don't think there's any of these up the other end, so I think this is a whole wave. We're at least managing slightly better. Just crowd controlling a little bit more efficiently, I think. A lot of this is just being close enough to the enemies that all your shots land, which is a little bit terrifying sometimes. I completely agree. And when those things split into the headless version, that's extremely annoying, because it's just another extra few shots that you have to take against them. Ah, we've got dips this time, so this might be okay. But getting close to a dip is a bad idea, because you never know which direction it's going to launch itself in, or when. It's very embarrassing to take damage to a dip, but it's also extremely easy, because you want to hit him. Well, that was a spider I took damage to, so I'm not so salty about that. I mean, at least you always play the easiest version of these, right? You always play the basement, you always play the caves. I don't know if that actually changes anything. Keep these at bay and then try and get rid of them. There we go. How much money? That's quite a lot of money, though. Hey, these don't do contact damage. I did not realize. How long have you been playing this game? We definitely take the latch key. Now I think about it, maybe we don't. Oh, it just gives us spirit hearts. We've got two keys and a spirit heart for the price of two keys and a spirit heart. So it's worth it. The luck may also be valuable. I don't know. Jesus juice is what we want, but whether we can afford it remains to be seen. Of course, we have a headless baby, which has zero help in this particular fight. Try and do as much damage to the actual boss as possible. Because we've only got so long to kill it, and it's spawning enemies, so get rid of the spawner. That's the obvious thing to do here. Please, leave me alone. I remember the first time I fought this thing, I was like, how the hell am I supposed to beat this enemy? The trick is, ignore those. Now we have another boss, but we've also got, you know, these things to worry about, but it's not that big a deal right now. It's only Monstro. I could easily get a nickel out of these poops, so I'm going to keep shooting them. Try and stop me. Monstro is affected by a headless baby as well, so we can just sort of try and keep our enemies closer sort of thing. Should be okay. Trying to actually get hit though. I don't think I'm going to be able to drag Headless Baby around Monstro in order to draw creep underneath Monstro. That'd be preposterous. But I've done some decent damage there. I'm happy. Headless Baby could be good in many other situations. We have 12 cents, which is not quite enough for Jesus Juice. And I don't think... Well, there's no bomb. I don't think I want to press the... I want to pull the trigger on using that. Coin beggar? I don't think anything it can give us is at all what I want. At least not right now. I think that just fired over the top of me and I just sort of stood there and hoped for the best. These things are all at different intervals. It's extremely difficult to track off. Are you making more? I don't want you to make more. I'm having enough trouble killing him as it is. You are making more. I'll just keep killing you then. Oh, what? Trap me in a corner. This enemy is doing an extremely good job at corralling me to where I don't want to be. So I'm going to go over here and sort of wait. Wow. Good job. I feel like I've demoralized myself to a considerable degree. I sort of want to go to sleep all of a sudden. Don't let the bastards get you down, man. Okay. This gives us a deal with the devil, which kills us anyway, no doubt. It's Krampus. Yeah, we're going to die. All we have to do is get hit and that's it. At least the fires are gone. Super easy to accidentally get hit by Krampus by being in the wrong place when it rotates or fires. Krampus can really trap you in the corner. Guaranteed damage, no doubt. Hey, we've got something decent for once, so I'm happy with this. We still don't have enough money to get what we want here, which is a crying shame. Nothing in there, nothing in there. Anything in here? Ooh, there could be a nickel in one of these, though. There's a cent! It's nearly there. One more cent. Nah. That's okay. There will be other Jesus juices or equivalents. And we get a free item on every floor anyway. I pressed F. I hope... Are you still recording? Yes. I accidentally pressed F, which unfull screens the game. No, I'm not taking Cursed Eye. That's a silly idea. I would like to take this, though. PhD's back. Yeah, I think we want Roid Rage again. So we can use Krampus' head when we start to get overwhelmed, basically, which has not happened yet. We appear to have at least an upgrade. Oh, great, well done. Because you've not fought those enemies a billion times. They're not something that was already in Rebirth, and you've not got 500 hours in that game. That'd be silly. Who would play a game for 500 hours? I feel like we actually took good care of those. Well, thanks for rotating so that you didn't actually have any effect. Krampus is bullshit. More like Krampus' leg. Works up a leg? At least those are easy to sort of crowd control early. You just run at them with your tears down, firing. And then there's generally enough tears to get rid of them just in that one run. There's a hole there that I couldn't see. This is definitely a spot. At least these things land on the creep that I was just, you know, creating. Oh, no, no, no. No, 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 no. You're not doing a full point of damage to me, you little son of a bitch. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. Wow. How many times are you going to get stuck on that same hole? Hole. Oh, come on. Get rid of these, they're shooting me. I don't like it. What is this, though? They don't shoot you when they're not at full size, right? So shoot them at all and they'll stop. Pick up all the money. Don't fight the bosses. 32 cents. We will take Roid Rage. Don't think you want to take meat. I want a freaking bomb, you son of a bitch. We'd probably take this. And count out the chickens. That they didn't get re-rolled there. Yeah, I know I mixed my metaphors. What? I was too busy looking at that, thinking, is it dead? I didn't even realise that I just sort of slid into pin. What a strange thing to have happened. Well, that's down. What have we got? Another haunt fight. Well, we know how this works. This haunt has decided to unleash the fury all at once. And these things are incredibly fast right now. Can we just put a little bit of a stop on this? I'm not sure I'm happy with the situation I find myself in. Right, this one creates spiders, but also does a spray of bullets. Okie dokie. In that case, this one does diagonal brimstone. Spiders and bullets. Normal bullets and spiders. So when it's doing that, there's going to be a spider and we don't care where. Because it's not going to be thrown at us, which is the important thing. Because it's still very rude. Still saying. Very rude to just launch spiders at people. Especially big ones split into two. You know? Mother spiders with two babies. Could at any point shoot bullets at us. And honestly, I think I prefer that attack when it's not near me. Rather than the spiders at any time. Okay, we got through this well enough. Even though we came very close to our ultimate doom. We need one more cent. Could buy a spirit heart. Might be a good idea. Or what we do is we press this and use Krampus' head to hurt ourselves, apparently, because I didn't expect it to be the explodey version. But we got through it, and that's important. It is a deal with the angel, which means we get free stuff. We got Godhead, legit. So I feel better about my tactics for getting Godhead last time. And I feel good about the idea that getting Crown of Light the same way might be what we choose to do. I'm gonna buy the Spirit Heart, and I'm not gonna buy more than one. Tell you why? No, I'm not gonna tell you why. You can guess. But all of a sudden, we are out of control. If we buy one Spirit Heart, that gives us a great chance to at least survive enough waves to get those 5 cents back, just from fighting the waves. Speed upgrade does help. Okay. But also, it gives us enough chance to survive. Well, there's a spirit heart right there. So now we've got way more opportunity to survive more waves. I don't really want either of these. So at some point, I'm going to think about re-rolling. The question is, do we want to play the arcade machine there, the fortune teller? The reason that's a question is that we have got a luck upgrade, which I paid for. And I did say maybe the luck is worth the extra, you know, the difference in money. Or rather, it's worth the fact that, like, it's a bonus on top of what we bought, which was basically... Oh my god. These motherfuckers! Did you see all that shit? I was trapped by the previous wave. I couldn't stop at that... Look. Everything is conspiring against me right now, and nothing is my fault. I just want you to know that. We've beaten off all 8 waves already, so we've got Krampus' head still available for the boss fights. If we need it. We have 32 cents. We will buy a key. And we'll also buy a spirit heart. I think there's always a key available. And then we'll start rerolling, basically. I mean, there's such an outside chance that we can reroll anything. I'm not going to take it. I might take it if... We are quite fast, so I'm considering maybe taking it if we don't get any other way of rerolling. Do we want black candle? Red candle. What do you think? Scorpio's pretty good. Is Red Candle repeatedly better than Krampus's head once in a while? I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll use Krampus's head now. I didn't want to stand on the button. Okay? I want you to stand in the middle and, you know, be a happy person for the rest of my life. Why do you hate happiness, game? Why will you not let me have nice things? Okay, I think Red Candle's probably the right way to go here. Because it's got so much potential, we can leave these fires knocking around. We can cajole things onto them, and we can throw them at things as well. And it recharges often. We can use it way more often than we can use Krampus's head. And if Krampus's head is a wash or a bust or whichever particular word you want to use that means it was shit, we're going to feel a lot better about, you know, the play we did make. Still can't really afford to go into any of these curse rooms. Oh, a little list as well, let's see. One of these creeps is mine. Oh, help. Which one? Ah, not that one. Whew. Probably all that. I assume... Ooh, we have to do it. And the reason we have to do it is it's the only way we're going to get any HP. But we did get Godhead. But now we're not going to get any more, unfortunately, deals with the angel. I don't think we want Mom's Key because it's not going to really help. I think we take poison tears. And we just be thankful for small mercies. Now that we have Abaddon and Godhead, which is a very interesting combination of items biblically, I'm feeling a lot better about it. And of course, this is now a 30-odd minute episode rather than the... Ooh, is that spun? No, because it's a different run. Ah, that's okay. Now we don't have any money. There's a bomb. It's over there. But we don't need the HP. We can reroll if we choose to, and we can also buy a key. Probably want to reroll. We don't want a space bar item, and HP is not worth 15 cents to us. Oh yeah, we're out of control. This is really good, provided I can avoid being shot by lasers from across the map. I'm out of space. Yeah, as long as I can avoid being hit by difficult things to dodge, our actual damage is more than adequate to get us through these things. So now it's just a case of, you know, point and shoot, and hope for the best when it comes to, yeah, being trapped in corners. Do you know what? Maybe don't stand in a corner. If you actually want to have a chance of dodging incoming bullets, don't fucking stand where there's nowhere to get out of the way. Didn't even use Red Candle, but we're probably going to want it for bosses. I think we reroll. I haven't really got much opportunity to buy a bomb recently either. I don't think tech will help us. Tech point 5 would. I do want to buy... Now, we've had blank card before, and that was a mistake not taking it. But back then we had only the poop as our space variety. Now we have something considerably better than the poop. Yeah, this is much better. That was also really good. So... I don't feel like blank card can be that much better than what we've already got going on for us. Look how much better our damage is, even against this enemy. Oh, oh, oh. Trying to land that on there is actually a little bit more difficult than you might imagine, because momentum is the thing. There we go. Try not to, by the way, shoot your own fire. Which I am doing because I don't really care. But... you can put it out, and you don't want to do that. Right, that should be spun. There we go. Now we've got way more damage than we need. So we're going to push this button. This is not something I'm a fan of, necessarily. See? I moved to one side. I was talking about this in a recent episode. These fishes are impossible to predict. It's literally impossible to predict the fishes. Don't try. As far as I can tell, the safest place is exactly in front of them. I don't know, even on average, they could still be... like, there could be no averagely correct space to stand. Or, maybe they aim at you. I hadn't considered that. Maybe I should have. I don't really want either of these. I don't want to spend that much money on Gimpy. Well, HP. I don't want to spend that much HP on Gimpy. Because I don't think, by now, it's sort of worth that much back, if that makes sense. Friends till the end is okay. but not very good. Not in this situation. We've been into both of our item rooms, so we just go down and hope maybe the next floor has a cheaper key. Doesn't really matter. I haven't got any bombs, so there's no point looking for tinted rocks. I think we're doing really well. For once. The money helps, actually. Hopefully there's a nickel in here. No nickel, but maybe we can buy something straight away. If nothing else, a key. So we can see what our other item is. Run! Get out of there! Yeah, there is a 3-cent key, so I was kind of right in some respect with that. Could also buy that spirit heart. We don't really need Charm of the Vampire, and honestly, there's literally no point taking it. It can do us no good. Well, it cannot do us any good. That usually means it's going to do us bad. It's not even going to do us bad. It's just useless. If we get any, we can kill these bomb flies near these fires. We get a good chance of getting... Wow, how many do you want to throw at me? Good chance of getting some spirit hearts out of the fires. That'd be nice. If anything wanted to explode near the fires at all, that would be sweet. That's not going to happen because we have no control over our tears because they are homing and the aura hurts as well. That was all 8 waves while I was just talking about collecting those fires. So you can see that we've become a lot more powerful than we were. If you strike me down now, I shall become more powerful than you can possibly imagine. Ooh, I do like Skinny Odd Mush. Skinny Odd Mush will drastically improve our rate of fire at the expense of some damage. But our damage is good enough. I think our rate of fire would only benefit from it. I'm very glad that Stain died before this one popped up. There we go. I completely missed with the red fire, but who cares? Oh, we've got another boss. Hello, other boss. Oh, right. The red fire, the red candle fire, actually blocks shots as well. Very much worth knowing. We will take this. The battery does us no good. The halo would be okay for us. 2 crampuses. That's a bit OP. Wah! No way of avoiding that. Even I wasn't fast enough, and I'm pretty fast right now. Still not a single bomb. I don't even think one's shown up. Empty vessel is actually extremely tempting right now. Do you know what? We can afford to take it because we'll have 2 HP left. We can fly now. It gives us HP. Didn't even know that. So that costs us 1 HP and then we'll buy one. So we're back to where we were. That's excellent. Now, because we're Blue Baby, empty vessel cannot fail to work. Probably should have gone to that curse room, but whatever. I'm pretty excited about this. We've managed to take 20 minutes on 2 runs and then another 20 minutes on 1 more run. And now we're ridiculously powerful. Don't even need this key. We have got a bomb all of a sudden. I wasn't not really down with that. If that's all right with you. We'll go to this curse room. It's a red chest. The red chest contains nothing but control bombs. We're going to take half a heart to find out. Do you want to take chaos? Sure. Not much use. Of course, we've got. We did pick up Swallow Penny, which has possibly been helping us out to some extent. Just sort of here and there. Getting hit occasionally, taking half heart damage, but at least it's given us the occasional extra. I'm confused by where I am. That's strange. The occasional extra penny might have actually helped us out in a couple of situations here. If we kill these before the timer goes off, then those things stop, which is extremely useful. And have invincibility right now as well. That's one of the main benefits of empty vessel here. Not just the flight, which is part of its effect. As long as you have 0 red HP, empty vessel will be active. Which is always true for Blue Baby, so it's always active. Managed to not actually take damage from those ghosts for once by walking into the freaking things. We've done okay here. We've got 18 cents. We've got 19 cents if we want them. Do you think car battery actually helps? I think it won't. I'm going to put this here. Hoping maybe to get something out of... I will take the orbs. Hopefully, hoping to get something out of that pot, but it didn't happen. A few more cents is probably not going to be too helpful for us right now. Where did all that money come from? Is that what I get for my diligence with taking Swallow Penny? I didn't expect to get that many of them. Pick it up! There we go. Right, we've got 13 cents. We can reroll and hope for a 7 cent item, but that's basically it. Oh, it's another cent out there, but whatever. Please. Okie dokie. 3 cent battery charge would have been great had we the D20, but we don't. We have no bombs. Let's just do this then. I'm very happy to have picked up Godhead completely at random on this run. Also, I really hate the way the Stain and the other ones do that. I think it's pretty shitty of them. Anything in here? 2 HP basically makes up for this whole floor. I mean, not only does it mean that we picked up Godhead legitimately, for once, literally the first time, in fact, but it means that this run has become that much extra good because all of our shots are ridiculously powerful. Nice. I mean, we don't need to do this. Obviously, we're only doing this because we hope to get those extra items at the end of it all. Use your invincibility while you can. You don't have any orbitals or anything, but, you know, get in there and don't worry about being hit is the point at this stage. Avoid being hit by these. It's kind of easy to get hit by these. That was BS. Also, how was that a full heart of damage? Excuse me. Not how this works. Don't let... So when coins drop, the greed can use them as HP, so don't let that happen. Don't appreciate how difficult those have been to avoid being hit by, to be honest. Every time you get hit on this fight, you will drop coins and greed will use them. Wow. Ban is a particularly difficult fight when you're not really not... Like, we've been super good at this from a standpoint of the actual waves that have been coming back. You know, it's not like we've been struggling on those. But this fight can be particularly hard because half the time you can't see the boss. So it's very difficult to know what's coming up. Especially when it shoots you from a distance. You weren't expecting it. Like, that happened to be in the right place to avoid that. Luckily, I was far enough away, basically. Quick, kill. What was that, Papa Roach? In Tony Hawk Pro Skater 2. Trying to get a perfect start on the school level. I remember doing this. You just keep restarting so that you can land in a manual. Ugh. Very bad. Don't die on this. That would be pretty embarrassing. You know, you've got the HP, you've got the expertise, you've got the dodge skills, you've got the godhead, you've got the rate of fire. You know how to fight this boss. You've got the bloody occasional ability to just take no damage. How are you doing this battle? Run away. Don't let these deal you any damage at all. Get rid of him ASAP. Godhead is enough to deal with these waves, so don't have to worry too much about the coins that have keys on, basically, is what I'm saying. Ooh, that was bullshit. You saw it. You saw it. How? how did those dodges work? I think it's just a matter of chance at this stage, you know? It's the same chance of me actually having one of those coins land on top of me versus the chance of it, you know, being literally anywhere else or rolling into me or something like that. Lots of chances are involved in this game right now, and we are nearly done, so... I mean, I'm pretty sure we've won here. I don't want to call it just yet, because at any point we could completely foul it up. Ruin everything in the nicest way. If only these things dropped something valuable to me, you know? Well, we're done. I'm happy with that. That was a 15-minute episode. I'm sorry it took so long. We'll put some money in here. Why not? But we did get Godhead. We didn't need Godhead. But it just shows that this is possibly the way to do it. Hopefully next time we at least don't roll Blue Baby or bloody the Keeper. Because, or The Lost, in fact. That's just going to be a really boring episode. But thank you for watching this one. I hope you enjoyed it. I actually enjoyed playing it because we managed to pick up Godhead properly for the first time. If you did enjoy it, you know what to do. Leave a like on the video. Leave a comment down below saying what I could improve. Probably I should stop talking complete shit. And remember to subscribe if you want to be notified about future episodes. But until the next episode, I hope that you will join me then. Good day.
Mark.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the Binding of Isaac, something birth. We're going to agree to run, but I'm going to random it, sort of mix it all up a little bit, you know, throw all the things in the fire, make it all fucking perfect. That's exactly what we wanted, is a fucking blue baby. Fucking greed run straight off the bat. Let's take 1 HP and make some poop. I think what we want to do here is see what's available. There is a chest. Probably spend our newfound spirit heart on this, which is actually a really good idea. Well done, me. Get rid of the poops. We want to make sure we've got as much room as possible, because on a greed mode run, you're going to have more trouble at the start of the game than you are further on, because once you get some money, you can start buying some items. No, I don't want that, but we do have the D6 in here, which is a much, much better spacebar item. So we can, once we get some cash... Why did that do that funny maneuver just now? Once we get some cash, we can think about finding ourselves taking the D6. Why have I not... Oh, I got some... Yes, we did get some more money. Very good. At some point, we're probably going to want to think about stepping on this button, because there's no way we have the DPS to keep up with this. But at the same time, I want to make sure we got enough money to buy the D6 sooner rather than later. The reason for that is that if we... Oh, that was a terrible dodge. If we do it wrong, well, first of all, we have to make sure we've got enough HP to actually step on this without hurting, without dying. This doesn't seem like it's going to last very long, if I had to guess. We want to, if possible, get as many charges on the D6 as we can. See, that's the problem right there. We can't afford anything, but we had to stop, but now we can't push the button the second time. Oh my god, the little son of a bitch was a chasey type one. Like, these things die easily, I guess, but same time, you don't really want to be in that situation. We can't push the button now. It's not an option. But we also do not have the DPS to beat this in the 10 seconds that it gives us to do so. So hopefully we can beat the next wave without too much trouble whilst this one is still going. Oh god, this is going to be awful. Oh, what happened? I'm alive. It's just a case of holding your breath at this point, hoping for the best. Try and stop the spiders from aggroing you, if possible. That way, you've got more room to maneuver dodging these shots. And the more of these little diglet thingies we can get out of the way, then the better we'll do. Well, we'll just keep doing this, I think. Let's see what's in this shop. There is a reroll, if we choose to accept it. Maybe going into the curse room was not the greatest of ideas. There is a coin in there, but it's not that big a deal at this stage. All stats is kind of a little bit better than just the single HP we got on the last one, but still not really giving us the start that we need. It's not the amazing upgrade. I mean, it's going to be a little bit difficult as Blue Baby at the start of this game, because it's not like we can take the Spirit Hearts from the shop, because there aren't any. We're not going to really benefit from any HP upgrades at all. I feel like I can probably ignore that head thingy for now. Actually, to be honest, this Halo pickup has actually made a considerable difference. We're not really getting any consumables from all of this, so... I guess a lot of the things that you'd normally expect to be a benefit to you are not going to happen. Which is why greed mode is just that much different, I suppose. But of course, as Blue Baby, we're not going to get any of the expected... benefits from any of the expected sources. Luckily, those things all helped me out with the wave that has been around for, you know, most of my adult life, apparently. And it's my favorite enemies of all time that I know exactly how to deal with. I think we're doing a lot better right now, so there is that, than we were on the previous one, where we were not doing well at all. This is the 8th wave as well, so we don't have to worry. Which means we've got the maximum benefit from the money for this, which... actually gives me a little bit more confidence than we had just now. We can buy... I think... although we could buy a key, there is more money coming up. There could be some money in here. Oh, okay. And I think wire coat hanger, the tier upgrade, is that much more important to us right now. And the soul. So, I don't want to call it a win. Obviously, we still have quite a lot of not dying to do. That's definitely part of it. Still blue baby. It's not like we've solved all of our problems, because one of our main problems is the fact that we are blue baby. But with the soul to keep us alive, with the coat hanger to keep us in good DPS, and the halo to actually make that DPS slightly better than it used to be. If I can kill this before the 5 seconds, that would be super good. There we go. I think it gives us an extra... Oh, what is this? I think it gives us an extra bit of cash if you finish it early. I know it gives you cash if you don't push the button. I really wish I had bombs right now. But I'm not sure if it gives you more cash if you finish before your time is up. Which would be nice, because of course more cash is more value. And we're here to get our final item, don't forget. That was a very interesting interaction, did you notice? Our soul pushed away a homing shot, and therefore had no idea what to do. Of course, we can't push the button now because we're stuck here. This is the last wave. You can't cancel the last wave. We're actually doing okay here. Ooh, that was a very timely jump, I have to be honest. You know, credit where credit's due. The game got me there. Having the soul push away tears that are trying to attract themselves to us is a very strange situation, but at least it didn't hit us. That's the important thing. We have 9 cents. Now, it could buy us another key, but there's no point buying a key really at this stage. And the reason for that, mostly, is it's 5 cents. It's always going to be 5 cents, but sometimes it could be 3 cents, so saying it's always going to be 5 cents was slightly a lie. Wow, you're down there, are you? They go a long way, actually. Very surprising how far these things can actually travel. At least we're doing some decent amount of damage to those things. The dips are popping in one shot, which just goes to show that Blue Baby with the halo is... much better damage upgrade than we've had from some of our runs more recently. I think this is fine. I'm trying to get this deal with the devil mostly for its own sake. There's a chance, of course, that we can't take it. Pretty good chance. And even in that situation, that still gives us the same deal with the angel sort of strategy, option, chance, dynamic, paradigm, etc. that you get in a normal run. So I think we can... not really afford to take this. I really hate these things because I have no idea how to hit them, because if you can hit them, they can hit you. Let's wait for them to teleport. So we've only got 4 spirit hearts, which is not good enough. I'm kind of tempted to spend one on the curse room, but I'm not going to do it. We haven't got any bombs to find a secret room either. Yeah, we've got some good stuff on this floor, so I'm happy with that. I'm really looking for a floor that has spirit hearts, but even better, the D20. So we get a free item, which is just 1 spirit heart, and I will take it. We could do the bomb then. There isn't one. But I suppose we buy the key, because there isn't a cheaper key. Don't really care about the only trinket that's available. I think the bombs are actually worth it, even though the other one is a theoretically better space where I am, especially down here. Hot bombs is A, bomb synergy, but B, it's some bombs. And honestly, I think it could be offensively useful, and also it can get us into stone chests and things like that. Otherwise, we would be at a loss to deal with, really. For example, we put this here. Of course, hot bombs will be creating the fires to make the bombs that we do have that much more offensively potent. So, I mean, it's a difficult choice. Having loads of extra coins, in principle, could have been really good, but it could have been shit. You know, variants could have just given us no extra coins at all out of all that. Unlikely. But still, we could have struck out on the coins from the wooden nickel, which would have been sad. We're really not doing a whole lot of damage to these things either. We're only on wave 5 of the 8 that we're going to have to deal with here. I didn't realise you were going to get behind me. That was very sneaky indeed. Hopefully these ones will just pop into nothingness. Yes, they do. Having a bit of trouble here, but I'm going to keep going. We are on wave 7, so we've basically got 1 left. Not that big a deal. We did get the 3 spirit hearts from the soul, so our HP is fine, but I have lost a lot, which is not too confidence-inducing. I'd like to get into... I don't know. I was going to say I'd like to get into the item room, but obviously we've been there. It wasn't that great. It wasn't hugely inspiring. Guess we'd do that. I don't really want either of these, either. This could be a secret room. It's not. Do you want to go into the curse room? It could do us some good. It could be shit. It's two keys. So that's basically 10 cents right there, which is one spirit heart's worth, but there's no spirit heart for sale, so... You know, we're not really getting the huge benefits that I would hope for, especially from greed mode. You know, we like to see slightly more interesting stuff in greed mode than we're currently receiving. I'm hoping... Unfortunately, they don't explode each other with each other's troll bombs. I'm hoping to see basically any of the fun you can get from just being able to buy infinite items. And if we can find the D20 and get our Crown of Light the same way we got our Godhead, then so be it. I have, you know, I've made peace, made my peace with that particular option. This is a champion version of the Haunt because it's throwing several of these little jokers at us all at once, which I don't like very much. They're so tanky for little shitbags like they are. Now, is this the one that's going to... No, it's a normal shot. It just had an extra ghost with it. Fair enough. We know how to deal with a Haunt, at least. I mean, first floor boss. Probably the harder of the first floor bosses, but we are not on the first floor. In fact, that's interesting. We are actually on the caves, and we're fighting the Haunt. And it nearly shot me, and I didn't let it, because I am a champion, mad... pro MLG level Isaac player, and don't you forget it. Well, I think we fight we fight our nightmare mode bosses, which is only a 3 sloths, so that's actually really good, because they can, if not hurt each other, they can at least explode these things that they create with their own shots and each other's. But hopefully we'll get a deal with the angel, maybe get our Crown of Light slightly more organically than trying to force it with cheap D20 plays. But look, we're playing Blue Baby on greed mode. That's a novelty in and of itself. And this time we have played nearly 2 whole floors of Blue Baby without dying miserably. It is another deal with the devil. Not my favourite, but at least we get some HP out of it. And again, we haven't got any precedent, so we could continue with the original plan, which is get Crown of Light from an angel, which is usually the only way you're going to do it. Is there anything we actually want in here? I mean, honestly, we save our money. If there's nothing we want, we save our money. I don't think the Lucky Foot is any value whatsoever in greed mode. Having a few extra bombs doesn't necessarily help from the matchbook there. So, I'm going to suggest no. We can always go straight into this shop, of course. There is a Spirit Heart, which will be replenishing, and it's only 5 cents. And there is a bomb. I don't think we take it yet. We see what's in the other ones. You know, we try and get as much of a play as we can. Well, there's a bunch of, hopefully, Spirit Hearts right here. Yes, 3. Very good. Well, that's us sorted on HP, at least for now. Which means what we can start doing is re-rolling these and hopefully get some sort of damage upgrade. I think we take the syringe, simply because it's a syringe. Now, this gives us money, and I can't remember how much. If we take it, it means we don't have to buy keys anymore. Well, we do have 2 keys. We should go into here. Honestly, I'm kind of hoping that we now get the D6 out of our rerolls here. I think we use bomb for this so that we have our money available to us to buy whatever else we want. It does reroll the whole shop, including the Spirit Heart there. Blank card is interesting, especially if a card drops somehow, or a chest appears, or anything really. There are many ways that blank card could be useful to us. You know, you could get a blank card Yera, for example, if a Yera rune somehow shows up, e.g. on the shop. You know, blank card Hierophant would be really good. These are all shop plays, by the way. I think the only way we can get any cards is to buy them from the shop. I'm not a fan of this this particular level right now. We haven't taken any damage yet, but that's more by luck than judgment. There you go. Took it. I'm going to push the button. I'm not afraid to admit when I am beaten, and I have been defeaterated. Honestly, I was not sure whether that beam would kill that enemy. Now that I know, in future I will make that play on purpose, but I should have stayed put, because then I wouldn't have, and I would not have been hit. I stepped aside, you see. A 7-cent black candle is definitely worth it, even though the chances of getting, some curse is not that great, and the curse is only going to last for 1 floor. Still not ideal to have found one. Well, that's right, we don't want to pick these up necessarily. Just a bit of a Hail Mary on a secret room here. It could be really anywhere, which is why I'm not trying too hard. I'm going to hold out hope. Keep playing these. We did get a damage upgrade. So we do have some... Look, it's a bit OP if you spend the entire time that I have to kill you unkillable. I'm just saying. You know, give me some chance. This guy is too fast. I can't kill him. Bombs. Got one. Fuck. Fires. Yeah, bring it on. Fires. Use the fire. Fire is your friend. It keeps you warm at night, cooks your food, kills the bacteria, denatures the proteins to make them more easily digestible. And you know, carbohydrates and things like that. Fire does a lot. Cooking food is very important. Something we figured out a long time ago as a species. And it's something that's been very good to us. That's not my creep, and I have no idea why I would think it was. That's doing quite a lot of damage here, so I'm happy with this. But this is brownie, and I'm not happy with that. I'll just drop a poop here. I can always hide behind it. I cannot hide behind it. I have shot it. Just don't be near it. Wow, okay. I don't know how to dodge these shots. It's bad enough when they're round and I can see where they are. When they're corn-shaped, I'm like, I have no idea. Some of the new Isaac enemies... I don't know, it's a bit weird. When I first saw Afterbirth played... Hello, you're this already. I was thinking, you know, these enemies seem out of place. It's weird. I don't know if that's just because they were new. I mean, they don't seem that out of place anymore, and I'm kind of used to it, but... this should be okay. Pardon me. Carrion Queen is not the easiest enemy by any stretch of the imagination, but at least we have a larger arena. I cannot believe that actually hit me just now. Mildly upsetting, I have to be honest. We have a larger arena. When this enemy is in a small room, it's basically impossible. Because there's nowhere to stand before it's turned around and shot you. It's not like Chubb. Chubb's hard enough to hit. At least we get our deal with the angel or devil. And don't forget, we don't have precedent, and it should use the same algorithm. Yeah, there we go. So we did get some HP, one of which is money, in principle. Do you want to reroll again, or I think we just go down to the next floor at this stage. I don't really think there's a huge amount of value in spending money to reroll those, except that you might be able to reroll them again before we run down to 15 cents and not be able to buy anything at all. But I mean, going down to the next floor is essentially rerolling anyway. We've got the same blinking item. Shoot the fire before it shoots you. We do have a reroll machine here as well, so we're kind of okay, but we'll check the free items first so that we don't reroll those items into these items and feel sad about it. We might as well take the belt. We probably should have taken Little Steven, actually, now that I remember the fact I didn't go in there. And then we'll take $3 bill. Honestly, the difference between having and not having Little Steven is not going to keep me awake, at least tonight. There's a second syringe, so that's what we really want there. And here's our card. It's the Two of Spades. It would have been nice to know that was coming up. I mean, oh, I didn't mean to do that. That happens far too often, but that's okay. It happens sometimes. Oh, of course, $3 bill is what's giving us these tier effects right now. And of course, being hit twice is not a big deal because it just gives us a bunch more money. It's just we'd like to postpone that until it's strictly necessary, if entirely possible. I think possibly taking blank cards should have been the thing that we do. That's not very much money, I'm being honest. Because there was some chance that we got a card eventually from all our rerolls, right? I mean, it doesn't seem infeasible that we would eventually have one. And the poop is doing nothing for us. So even the potential in blank card is greater than the potential in the poop, even though the poop has some fairly decent potential, especially in terms of spirit hearts. Help. Let me out. I'll just put a poop here, that'll help. Oh my god, I hate these fucking creatures. Have you seen these things? They won't leave me the fuck alone. At least I don't have to push the button. Like, we've run out of button plays. I will use the black heart There is creep that I cannot see. That's not very fair. I'm just being honest. Oh my god. And that's why I hate those creatures. Oh, I'm going to shit myself. Yeah, there's way more potential in blank card than there ever was in the poop. But we did have 15 more cents when we came down to this floor. Is blank card two of spades that big a deal? I will take the torn photo and hope that we can re-roll into, I don't know, anything. I'm not a fan of this, though. Okay, it's just four of these. And by just, I mean, oh my god, it's four of these. But at least it's not multiple... Ah, oh, fuck. Of the stain? Multiple stain would be much harder. Trying to dodge more than one of those on the same room doing the same attack would be nigh on impossible, I have no doubt. Yes, frozen. I nearly got caught on that rock there. Just wait for the creeps to dissipate. I can see it now. We got Curse of the Darkness. No, because we got the Black Candle. How could we possibly have Curse of Darkness? It's kind of pesky when we have the Polycephalus tier effect. But we don't have the Polycephalus damage upgrade. Which means we have no range and no damage. Downsides of decent items is that often they have downsides, I guess. That's one of these. Polycephalus or Polyphemus? It's Polycephalus. Begone with your creep. Good. Well, that was a lot of effort. Maybe we can buy something. Like a spirit heart. No. Do you want to try the reroll? I think we try the reroll. We could always end up with just enough money anyway as a result of the poop. And also this room, and also this round. Oh god, it's fucking two fucking champions of these bastards. Do not like champions of these bastards! Look at that! Fucking threw a spider right at me, which is extremely rude in any polite society. You don't know how I feel about spiders. It's a bit of an assumption that you've made there. Very presumptuous of you to assume that I would appreciate a gift of a spider. Especially one launched at me. Maybe if you presented to me in a nice velvet case, we might have, I might have felt differently about this, but as it stands, don't like this, Polyphemus nonsense right now. Our damage is good enough to at least get rid of those things before they infest the map completely and become a problem. This is what we like to see. Death's Touch versus these spiders. Even just the piercing aspect of those is super helpful. We have got rid of one. Very pleased to see that. And I don't know where I was when it threw it. That's the problem. Nor do I know. What's happening? Let's go again. I mean, it might not last. It might not last long enough for the fact that we're on 20 minutes to matter. We're very slow. We have shit damage. This was an upsetting roll of Blue Baby here. But so be it. Oh my god, give me these things to start with. Try not to shoot that bomb, because that might be extremely useful at some point. At least these are only two shots each, but you have to land them both. Good. Two, three, one, two. Oh, one, two, three. Three, one, two. One, two, three. Get in there, kill it. Oh god, they're after me. They're coming right for us. I don't think there's any of these up the other end, so I think this is a whole wave. We're at least managing slightly better. Just crowd controlling a little bit more efficiently, I think. A lot of this is just being close enough to the enemies that all your shots land, which is a little bit terrifying sometimes. I completely agree. And when those things split into the headless version, that's extremely annoying, because it's just another extra few shots that we have to take against them. Ah, we've got dips this time, so this might be okay. But getting close to a dip is a bad idea, because you never know which direction it's going to launch itself in, or when. It's very embarrassing to take damage to a dip, but it's also extremely easy, because you want to hit him. Well, that was a spider I took damage to, so I'm not so salty about that. I mean, at least you always play the easiest version of these, right? You always play the basement, you always play the caves. I don't know if that actually changes anything. Let's keep these at bay and then try and get rid of this Joker. There we go. How much money? That's quite a lot of money, though. Hey, these don't do contact damage. I did not realize. How long have you been playing this game? We definitely take the latch key. Now I think about it, maybe we don't. Oh, it just gives us spirit hearts. We've got two keys and a spirit heart for the price of two keys and a spirit heart. So it's worth it. The luck may also be valuable. I don't know. Jesus juice is what we want, but whether we can afford it remains to be seen. Of course, we have a headless baby, which has zero help in this particular fight. Try and do as much damage to the actual boss as possible. Because we've only got so long to kill it, and it's spawning enemies. So get rid of the spawner. That's the obvious thing to do here. Please, leave me alone. I remember the first time I fought this thing. I was like, how the hell are you supposed to beat this enemy? The trick is, ignore those. Now we have another boss, but we've also got, you know, these things to worry about. But it's not that big a deal right now. It's only Monstro. Monstro it. We could easily get a nickel out of these poops, so I'm going to keep shooting them. Try and stop me. Also, it's affected by a headless baby as well, so if we can just sort of try and keep our enemies closer sort of thing, then we should be okay. I'm trying to actually get hit, though. I don't think I'm going to be able to drag headless baby around Monstro in order to draw creep underneath Monstro. That would be preposterous. Done some decent damage here. I'm happy. Headless baby could be good in many other situations. We have 12 cents, which is not quite enough for Jesus juice. And I don't think... Well, there's no bomb. I don't think I want to press the... I want to pull the trigger on using that... coin beggar? I don't think anything it can give us is at all what I want. At least not right now. I think that just fired over the top of me, and I just sort of stood there and hoped for the best... These things are all at different intervals, and it's extremely difficult to keep track of. Are you making more? I don't want you to make more. I'm having enough trouble killing him as it is. You are making more. Well, we'll just keep killing you then. Oh, what? Trap me in a corner. This enemy is doing an extremely good job at corralling me to where I don't want to be. So I'm going to go over here and just sort of wait. Wow. Good job. I feel like I've demoralized myself to a considerable degree. I sort of want to go to sleep all of a sudden. Don't let the bastards get you down, man. There we go. This gives us a deal with the devil, which kills us anyway, no doubt. It's Krampus. Yeah, we're going to die. All we have to do is get hit, and that's it. At least the fires have gone. Super easy to accidentally get hit by Krampus by being in the wrong place when it rotates, or fires. Krampus can really trap you in a corner. Guaranteed damage, no doubt. Hey, we've got something decent for once, so I'm happy with this. We still don't have enough money to get what we want here, which is a crying shame. Nothing in there, nothing in there. Anything in here? Ooh, there could be a nickel in one of these, though. There's a cent. It's nearly there. One more cent. Nah. That's okay. There will be other Jesus juices or equivalents. And we get a free item on every floor anyway. I pressed F. I hope you... Are you still recording? Yes. I accidentally pressed F, which unfull screens the game. No, I'm not taking Cursed Eye. That's a silly idea. I would like to take this, though. PhD's back. Yeah, I think we want Roid Rage again. So we can use Krampus' head when we start to get overwhelmed, basically, which has not happened yet. We appear to have at least an upgrade. Oh, great, well done. Because you've not fought those enemies a billion times. They're not something that was already in Rebirth, and you've not got 500 hours in that game. That'd be silly. Who would play a game for 500 hours? I feel like we actually took good care of those. Well, thanks for rotating so that you didn't actually have any effect. Krampus' bullshit head. More like Krampus' leg. Wurt's other leg? No? These should be okay. Get rid of these. At least those are easy to sort of crowd control early. You just run at them with your tears down, firing. And then... It's generally enough tears to get rid of them. Just in that one run. There's a hole there that I couldn't see. This is definitely Curse of Darkness. Yeah. At least these things land on the creep that I was just, you know, creating. Oh, no. You're not doing a full point of damage to me, you little son of a bitch. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. Wow. How many times are you going to get stuck on that same hole? Hole. Oh, come on. Get rid of these, they're shooting me. I don't like them. What is this, though? They don't shoot you when they're not at full size, right? So just shoot them at all and they'll stop. Pick up all the money. Don't fight the bosses. 32 cents. We will take Roid Rage. Don't think you want to take meat. I want a freaking bomb, you son of a bitch. We'd probably take this. And count out the chickens that they didn't get re-rolled there. Yeah, I know I mixed my metaphors. What? I was too busy looking at that, thinking, is it dead? I didn't even realise that I just sort of slid into pin. What a strange thing to have happened. Well, that's down. What have we got? Another haunt fight. Well, we know how this works. This haunt has decided to unleash the fury all at once. And these things are incredibly fast right now. Can we just put a little bit of a stop on this? I'm not sure I'm happy with the situation I find myself in. Right, this one creates spiders, but also does a spray of bullets. Okie dokie. In that case, this one does diagonal brimstone. Spiders and bullets. Normal bullets and spiders. Okay. So when it's doing that, there's going to be a spider and we don't care where. Because it's not going to be thrown at us, which is the important thing. Because it's still very rude. Still saying. Very rude to just launch spiders at people. Especially big ones that split into two. You know? Mother spiders with two babies. It could at any point shoot bullets at us. And honestly, I think I prefer that attack when it's not near me. Rather than the spiders at any time. Okay, we got through this well enough. Even though we came very close to our ultimate doom. We need one more cent. We could buy a spirit heart. Might be a good idea. Or what we do is we press this and use Krampus's head to hurt ourselves, apparently, because I didn't expect it to be the explodey version. But we got through it, and that's the important thing. It is a deal with the angel, which means we get free stuff. We got Godhead, legit. So I feel better about my tactics for getting Godhead last time. And I feel good about the idea that getting Crown of Light the same way might be what we choose to do. I'm going to buy the Spirit Heart, and I'm not going to buy more than one. Tell you why? No, I'm not going to tell you why. You can guess. Wow, all of a sudden, we are out of control. If we buy one Spirit Heart, that gives us a great chance to at least survive enough waves to get those 5 cents back. Just from fighting the waves. Speed upgrade does help. Okay. But also, it gives us enough chance to survive. Well, there's a Spirit Heart right there. So now we've got way more opportunity to survive more waves. I don't really want either of these. So at some point, I'm going to think about re-rolling. The question is, do we want to play the arcade machine there, the fortune teller? The reason that's a question is that we have got a luck upgrade, which I paid for. And I did say maybe the luck is worth the extra, you know, the difference in money. Or rather, it's worth the fact that, like, it's a bonus on top of what we bought, which was basically, oh my god, these motherfuckers! Did you see all that shit? I was trapped by the previous wave. I couldn't stop at that. Look. Everything is conspiring against me right now, and nothing is my fault. I just want you to know that. But we've beaten all 8 waves already, so we've got Krampus's head still available for the boss fights. If we need it. We have 32 cents. We will buy a key. And we'll also buy a spirit heart. I think there's always a key available. And then we'll start rerolling, basically. I mean, there's such an outside chance that we can reroll anything. I'm not going to take it. I might take it if we are quite fast. So I'm considering maybe taking it if we don't get any other way of re-rolling, do we want Black Candle? Red Candle? What do you think? Scorpio's pretty good. Is Red Candle repeatedly better than Krampus's Head once in a while? I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll use Krampus's Head now. I didn't want to stand on the button. Okay? I want you to stand in the middle and, you know, be a happy person for the rest of my life. Why do you hate happiness, game? Why will you not let me have nice things? Yeah, I think Red Candle's probably the right way to go here. Because it's got so much potential. We can leave these fires knocking around. We can cajole things onto them, and we can throw them at things as well. And it recharges often. We can use it way more often than we can use Krampus's Head. And if Krampus's Head is a wash or a bust or whichever particular word you want to use that means it was shit, we're going to feel a lot better about, you know, the play we did make. Still can't really afford to go into any of these curse rooms. Oh, a little lust as well, you say. One of these creeps is mine. Oh, help. Which one? Ah, not that one. Phew. Probably all that. I assume... Ooh, we have to do it. And the reason we have to do it is it's the only way we're going to get any HP. But we did get Godhead. But now we're not going to get any more, unfortunately, deals with the angel. I don't think we want Mom's Key because it's not going to really help. But I think we take Poison Tears. I mean, just be thankful for small mercies. Now that we have Abaddon and Godhead, which is a very interesting combination of items biblically, I'm feeling a lot better about ourselves. And of course, this is now a 30-odd minute episode rather than the 20 minute. Ooh, is that spun? No, because it's a different run. Ah, that's okay. Now we don't have any money. There's a bomb. It's over there. But we don't need the HP. We can reroll if we choose to, and we can also buy a key. Probably want to reroll. We don't want a spacebar item, and HP is not worth 15 cents to us. Oh yeah, we're out of control. This is really good, provided I can avoid being shot by lasers from across the map, from outer space. Yeah, as long as I can avoid being hit by difficult things to dodge, our actual damage is more than adequate to get us through these things. So now it's just a case of, you know, point and shoot, and hope for the best when it comes to, yeah, being trapped in corners. Do you know what? Maybe don't stand in a corner. If you actually want to have a chance of dodging incoming bullets, don't fucking stand where there's nowhere to get out of the way. Didn't even use Red Candle, but we're probably going to want it for bosses. I think we reroll. I haven't really got much opportunity to buy a bomb recently either. I don't think tech will help us. Tech point 5 would. Oh, I do want to buy... Now, we've had blank card before, and that was a mistake not taking it. But back then we had only the poop as our spacebar item. Now we have something considerably better than the poop. Yeah, this is much better. That was also really good. So... I don't feel like blank card can be that much better than what we've already got going on for us. Look how much better our damage is, even against this enemy. Oh. Trying to land that on there is actually a little bit more difficult than you might imagine, because momentum is the thing. There we go. Try not to, by the way, shoot your own fire. Which I am doing because I don't really care. You can put it out, and you don't want to do that. Right, that should be spun. There we go. Now we've got way more damage than we need. So we're going to push this button. This is not something I'm a fan of, necessarily. See? I moved to one side. I was talking about this in a recent episode. These fishes are impossible to predict. It's literally impossible to predict the fishes. Don't try. As far as I can tell, the safest place is exactly in front of them. I don't know, even on average, they could still be... Like, there could be no averagely correct space to stand. Or, maybe they aim at you. I hadn't considered that. Maybe I should have. I don't really want either of these. I don't want to spend that much money on Gimpy. Well, HP. I don't want to spend that much HP on Gimpy. Because I don't think by now, it's sort of worth that much back, if that makes sense. Friends till the end is okay, but not very good. Not in this situation. We've been into both of our item rooms, so we just go down and hope maybe the next floor has a cheaper key. Doesn't really matter. I haven't got any bombs, so there's no point looking for tinted rocks. I think we're doing really well. For once. The money helps, actually. Hopefully there's a nickel in here. No nickel, but maybe we can buy something straight away. If nothing else, a key. So we can see what our other item is. Run! Get out of there! Yeah, there is a 3-cent key, so I was kind of right in some respect to have done that. Could also buy that spirit heart. We don't really need Charm of the Vampire, and honestly, there's literally no point taking it. It can do us no good. Well, it cannot do us any good. That usually means it's going to do us bad. It's not even going to do us bad. It's just useless. If we get any... If we can kill these bomb flies near these... fires, we get a good chance of getting a... Wow, how many do you want to throw at me? Good chance of getting some spirit hearts out of the fires, so... That'd be nice. If anything wanted to explode near the fires at all, that would be sweet. That's not going to happen because we have no control over our tears because they are homing and the aura hurts as well. That was all 8 waves while I was just talking about collecting those fires, so you can see that we've become a lot more powerful than we were. If you strike me down now, I shall become more powerful than you can possibly imagine. Ooh, I do like Skinny Odd Mush. Skinny Odd Mush will drastically improve our rate of fire at the expense of some damage, but our damage is good enough. I think our rate of fire would only benefit from it. I'm very glad that stain died before this one popped up. There we go. I completely missed with the red fire, but who cares? Oh, we've got another boss. Hello, other boss. Oh, right. The red fire, the red candle fire, actually blocks shots as well. Very much worth knowing. We will take this. The battery does us no good. The halo would be okay for us. 2 Krampuses. That's a bit OP. Wah! No way of avoiding that. Even I wasn't fast enough, and I'm pretty fast right now. Still not a single bomb. I don't even think one's shown up. Empty vessel is actually extremely tempting right now. Do you know what? We can afford to take it, because we'll have 2 HP left. We can fly now. It gives us HP. Didn't even know that, so that costs us 1 HP, and then we'll buy one. So we're back to where we were. That's excellent. Now, because we're Blue Baby, empty vessel cannot fail to work. Probably should have gone to that curse room, but whatever. I'm pretty excited about this. We've managed to take 20 minutes on 2 runs, and then another 20 minutes on 1 more run. And now we're ridiculously powerful. Don't even need this key. We have got a bomb all of a sudden. I wasn't not really down with that, if that's all right with you. We'll go to this cursed room. It's a red chest. The red chest contains nothing but troll bombs, but we're going to take half a heart to find out. Do you want to take chaos? Sure. Not much use. Of course, we've got. We did pick up Swallow Penny, which has possibly been helping us out to some extent. Just sort of here and there. Getting hit occasionally, taking half heart damage, but at least it's given us the occasional extra... I'm confused by where I am. That's strange. The occasional extra penny might have actually helped us out in a couple of situations here. If we kill these before the timer goes off, then those things stop, which is extremely useful. We have invincibility right now as well. That's one of the main benefits of empty vessel here. Not just the flight, which is part of its effect. As long as you have 0 red HP, empty vessel will be active. Which is always true for Blue Baby, so it's always active. Managed to not actually take damage from those ghosts for once by walking into the freaking things. We've done okay here. We've got 18 cents. We've got 19 cents if you want them. Do you think car battery actually helps? I think it won't. I'm going to put this here. Hoping maybe to get something out of... I will take priority. Hopefully, hoping to get something out of that pot, but it didn't happen. A few more cents is probably not going to be too helpful for us right now. Where did all that money come from? Is that what I get for my diligence with taking Swallow Penny? I didn't expect to get that many of them. Pick it up! There we go. Right, we've got 13 cents. We can reroll and hope for a 7-cent item, but that's basically it. Oh, it's another cent out there, but whatever. Please. Okie dokie. 3 cent battery charge. Would have been great had we the D20, but we don't. We have no bombs. Let's just do this then. I'm very happy to have picked up Godhead completely at random on this run. Also, I really hate the way the Stain and the other ones do that. I think it's pretty shitty of them. Anything in here? 2 HP basically makes up for this whole floor. I mean, not only does it mean that we picked up Godhead legitimately, for once. Literally the first time, in fact. But it means that this run has become that much extra good because all of our shots are ridiculously powerful. Nice. I mean, we don't need to do this. Obviously, we're only doing this because we hope to get those extra items at the end of it all. Use your invincibility while you can. You don't have any orbitals or anything, but, you know, just get in there and don't worry about being hit is the point at this stage. Avoid being hit by these. It's kind of easy to get hit by these. That was BS. Also, how was that a full heart of damage? Excuse me. That's not how this works. Don't let... So when coins drop, the greed can use them as HP, so don't let that happen. Don't appreciate how difficult those have been to avoid being hit by, to be honest. Every time you get hit on this fight, you will drop coins and greed will use them. Wow. I find this particularly difficult fight when you're not really not... Like, we've been super good at this from a standpoint of the actual waves that have been coming by. You know, it's not like we've been struggling on those. But this fight can be particularly hard because... half the time you can't see the boss. So it's very difficult to know what's coming up. Especially when it shoots you from a distance. You weren't expecting it. Like, that whew, happened to be in the right place to avoid that. Luckily, I was far enough away, basically. Quick, kill. Kill, kill, kill. What was that, Papa Roach? Fucking Tony Hawk Pro Skater 2. Trying to get a perfect start on the school level. I remember doing this. You just keep restarting so that you can land in a manual. Ugh! Very bad. Don't die on this. That would be pretty embarrassing. You know, you've got the HP, you've got the expertise, you've got the dodge skills, you've got the godhead, you've got the rate of fire. You know how to fight this boss. You've got the bloody occasional ability to just take no damage. How are you doing this badly? Run away. Don't let these deal you any damage at all. Get rid of him ASAP. Godhead is enough to deal with these waves, so don't have to worry too much about the coins that have keys on, basically, is what I'm saying here. Ooh, that was bullshit. You saw it. You saw it. How did those dodges work? I think it's just a matter of chance at this stage, you know. It's the same as the chance of me actually having one of those coins land on top of me versus the chance of it, you know, being literally anywhere else or rolling into me or something like that. Lots of chances are involved in this game right now, and we are nearly done, so... I mean, I'm pretty sure we've won here. But I don't want to call it just yet, because at any point we could completely foul it up. Ruin everything in the nicest way. If only these things drop something valuable to me, you know? Well, we've done. I'm happy with that. That was a 15-minute episode. I'm sorry it took so long. We'll put some money in here. Why not? But we did get Godhead. We didn't need Godhead. But it just shows that this is possibly the way to do it. Hopefully next time we at least don't roll Blue Baby or bloody the Keeper. Because, or The Lost, in fact. That's just going to be a really boring episode. But thank you for watching this one. I hope you enjoyed it. I actually enjoyed playing it because we managed to pick up Godhead properly for the first time. If you did enjoy it, you know what to do. Leave a like on the video. Leave a comment down below saying what I could improve. Probably I should stop talking complete shit. And remember to subscribe if you want to be notified about future episodes. But until the next episode, I hope that you will join me then. Good day.